Hi, Carrie. This is what I don't get. I see this whimsy stick stuff everywhere. It's in the magazines, in your book. And I know that you wrap ribbon around this thing, but how do you get it off there without it falling apart, and then sew it and wrap it and twist it? And how do you fold it and do it?
I'm going to show you.
Okay, so if I could see it, I'll understand better how to write it in the magazine and stuff.
Okay.
Okay.
Here's, start here.
Ooh.
I'm making it easy on you. And,
wow.
And we're going to tape.
You thought of everyone.
So we're just going to twist our stick to wrap the ribbon,
oh,
right?
Oh, so you have some space in there.
Well, we're going to,
okay,
oh, definitely, right?
Right?
It doesn't have to be perfect. We don't like perfect.
Okay, no, I hate measuring.
No, right?
Yes.
We like faster, easier. And look, now
yes,
it's good.
Okay.
But look, see, it's also looser.
Yes.
So we can get it off the stick.
Oh, I get it.
Right now.
If you wrapped it better together, it would be all tied on
right,
the stick.
Right, right. Okay. So we'll just wrap a little bit, and then we're going to get our tape out. Now, you're going to use a low-tack tape, or I just
tiger
have a...
tape.
Tiger tape. I just have a narrow masking tape, and I'm actually going to tape down both sides, both edges, excuse me, and then we're actually going to turn it over and tape the other side as well,
okay.
Right? So they're secure.
All right.
Then we're going to take this tape off the start, and we're going to slide it off.
Oh, I get it now. Okay.
Right?
Okay.
But look, I have another sample that's perfect.
All right, here's another good question. How do you keep your presser foot from catching into that?
Well, we're not going to sew over there. We're going to sew over here.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so you can sew down the center or slightly off center, right?
Okay.
Okay, and then once you're done, we're going to take the tape off just one side.
Okay.
Right? And then, but we're going to leave it on this side because it helps feed through the machine.
All right.
All right, and then we're going to fold that almost in half.
Okay.
Right? Offset the piece.
See,
yep.
See, uh-huh.
And then we're going to sew again right along the edge.
Oh, so that's why you left your tape on. That's a great idea.
We're doing
that. Otherwise, these things would be flipping up, getting in
they
the
don't
way.
Behave at all.
No.
No,
okay.
Right?
Yes.
And so that gives us double loop trim that looks like this.
That's great.
They're all perfectly spaced.
Uh-huh.
They offset when you fold them in half.
And then when you turn them in a circle, they all just loosen up. Is that what happens?
Well, this is kind of wide for that, but it makes a great rose. Can
okay.
I show you the rose?
Yeah, show me the rose.
Okay, so I'm going to take a scrap of ribbon, and I'm just going to tie a knot. Now, this is double-sided satin.
Okay.
So I'm going to tie it with the opposite color on the outside for my center, so it contrasts.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Now, I have my double loop trim that I've already made.
Okay.
I'm going to pick out that last one, so I have a little tail, and I'm going to put all my tails together.
Okay.
All right? Now, I'm just going to go. It's so hard, Kathy. Watch mm-hmm. Watch out. You better pay attention. One.
Oh, my God, you're going too fast. No,
okay.
Kidding.
Two. Okay, we're done.
Really?
Now we're done.
Put that tightly around.
No. Well, I'm kind of pinching it off to the side because I'm holding it, right?
Right, right.
But for now, so I'm going to just stick pins all the way across to
uh-huh.
hold it, and then I'll center that
okay.
once I can let go,
yeah.
right? And I'll trim my tail, and I'll get a needle and thread. And then I'm going to just simply tack.
Oh, and you just hide all that stuff underneath.
I'm going to go all the way across with my needle,
uh-huh.
move over a half inch all
right.
the way across.
Yeah, like your blue thread right here.
Yep.
Oh,
and
I see that.
See how loose I wrapped and how big
there?
My stitches mm-hmm. are?
That's great.
Don't pull it any
okay.
tighter because
yeah.
it'll look like a carnation. We want
right.
a rose. Tie a knot, you're done.
And then you can tack that onto your garment through the back of the fabric.
Anything. Put a pin back on it, then it's removable. You can put it on any outfit you want.
I can't believe that.
This is
gorgeous.
Three wraps around. This is two wraps around.
That's beautiful. And then this is just a thinner, a narrower ribbon, right?
Well, actually, this is single loop. You're going to wrap your stick, and when you get it to here, you're going to put tape down the middle instead.
Okay.
And we're going to sew right along the edge like this.
Oh, that's how you sew on the edge.
Right?
Okay, yes.
Take the tape off, no folding. It's just sew
sewing.
One time.
Yeah.
But you take your end and you just simply wrap around just like we did. We didn't even make a flower center for this one.
Oh my gosh, that's pretty. How on earth did you come up with this?
I have no idea.
Oh man. You didn't
and
get
that's
any
it.
Sleep one night. That's great.
And that's it. That's how you use a whimsy stick.
Well, I've seen them. I just didn't get the concept. I thought, okay, so you wrap it on the thing, and
well,
I'm thinking, how do you sew it? But you slide it off of here, and the
yes,
tape holds it
yes.
together.
And it doesn't have to just be about flowers.
Velvet.
It can be trim. You can use it with piping. You can, collars, trim ready-made clothes, all kinds of things. It's really fun.
Great.